Now, for more than 2 months after sports stopped, and after weeks of round-the-clock discussions with medical experts and professional sports bodies, I'm delighted to announce today that the government has published guidance which allows competitive sport to resume behind closed doors from Monday at the earliest, and crucially, only when it's safe to do so. It's up to each individual sport to decide exactly when to resume competition. They know their sports best. But football, tennis, horse racing, Formula One, cricket, golf, rugby, snooker and others are all set to return to our screens shortly, with horse racing first out of the gate in the North East next week. It's been a huge challenge to get to this point. We've taken a forensic, clinician-led approach, working with Public Health England and the Department of Health every step along the way. And we've had dozens of meetings and published pages of detailed guidance outlining first how to get athletes back into socially distanced training and then back into close contact training. And throughout all of this, we've put the safety of the athletes, coaches and support staff first and foremost. And by working so closely with the sports themselves, we've made sure that it's been a collaborative, consensual effort to create the safest possible environments for everyone involved. Now, the guidance outlines various measures that need to be in place for an event to go ahead and to keep everyone involved safe. That includes a screening process for coronavirus symptoms at the venue, a one-way system for people and vehicles, minimising the use of dressing rooms, and of course, maintaining social distancing wherever that is possible. And as all sports fully recognise, ensuring the mental health of their athletes and staff is as important as their physical health, particularly in these very difficult times, and our guidance today reinforces that. It's taken a lot of hard work to get us here today, so thank you to everyone involved, and I know that this will be welcome news for many.